think that some Christmases take more effort than others to get in the right mood. And this was one of those Christmases. So we're going to show you how we got in the spirit with love for a country house. We looked around our house for things that we already had that we wanted to make into decorations. So we had a lot of these hydrangea blossoms that were dried. They didn't have much color left, so we spray painted them with two shades of blue, sky blue and tropical blue, and some warm red that was sort of like cranberry, and a lime green that sort of made all the colors blend together. If you think your colors are too intense, just give it a little film of a light coat of the lime, and it will really make these blossoms look more natural. You don't have to go for complete coverage on these blossoms. You can just do the paint in spots, and you can use more than one color on the blossoms. We used this artificial tree that was very sparse. It doesn't have a lot of branches, so it was perfect for filling in with the dried flowers. We had to use really lightweight decorations too, because it's fragile and it rains this confetti of blossoms and petals everywhere. But we still love it so much, we're going to bring it back out for Easter without the decorations and just let the pastel colors that remind us so much of spring. Here it is at night on the left side of the fireplace. And we love to decorate with dried flowers. In fact, we went through the house and we found every dried flower we could find, and we decided to attach them to this wire frame that we'd thrifted from a Goodwill store. We spray painted it rust color and we filled it with sphagnum moss and preserved moss and some reindeer moss too. Then we went through our house plants and cut some herbs. And we used all these different dried flowers and petals, and we found we had zinnias, we had carnations, we had hydrangea, we had some lilac, and some orchids, and what else? Let's see, some wildflowers there. Oh, the rose hips too. And it's amazing how much color, like see the Christmas cactus there at the top? It retains a lot of color when it's dried. Now for that dollhouse, we found it. We were driving down the road one day. I saw it on the curb, and I was the one that said, "Stop the car." And I'd always wanted to make it into a Christmas display. We used opaque placemats, white, and double stick tape, and some satin ribbons. We taped them on the front of the dollhouse so we could line everything up. And it makes it look like stained glass windows, even though it's fabric and plastic. And we use some blocks for the chimney, and we use two types of glue. The hot glue holds everything instantly, and the wood glue is much stronger. We also use some pipe cleaners to make these little wreaths. They're held on with paper clips, and we made a little Christmas tree with a battery-powered lights for the center of the window. I think this dollhouse is meant to be a high school, but we love it. It's so romantic. It kind of looks like a city house, and our old house is in a small town, and it's kind of sweet to come into the old house right off the street where there's so many old buildings and then see this as the main display over the fireplace. And so let's get that wreath straight. As you can see, everything's kind of thrown together, but I think that looks nice for Christmas, especially if you can manage to put a little bit of air and space between the objects when you come back through and adjust everything. This is a tree we made in the past that we spray painted blue, and then we used silk flowers all over it. And that was it for Christmas this year. We hope you had a good one, and we hope you subscribe to steffymccarthy.com here on YouTube, and visit our website too.